when you're using a mold, you can get hundreds of isotopes that are all identical. Now, ice carving is an artwork that has been passed down normally from father to son or grandfather to grandson within the family, with different generations. And of course, our two master carvers here have learned their skills and have been honing them here on board the Royal Princess. Now, when you start learning the art of ice carving, of course, these blocks of ice are very, very difficult to find out. So for our carvers, they've been practiced. I think it's Holly's Diary. And with the Holly's Diary, you can, of course, draw your beautiful design and then you start practicing carving. Now, something to be very mindful of when carving is to make sure that the ice carving is balanced. Of course, if you make something like a flamingo or an ostrich, something with very thin legs, that ice carving is very easily going to be taking a long dive once it starts to melt. You have to be very, very careful about the balance.
No,
is